About the laws of chemical combination. So in continuation with that, we are with the first law of chemical combination and few numerical problems. So let us start with. Here, the first law of conservation is, as we read in the previous lecture, that the law of conservation says that the mass of the reactants will always be equal to the mass of the product. So on that concept, we have a numerical with us. So let us read it first of all, that what the numerical says, that when 4.2 gram of NaHCO3 is added to 10 gram of acetic acid, 2.2 gram of CO2 is released and 12 gram of residue is formed. Show that these data is in agreement with the law of conservation of mass. So now, first of all, we have to decide that what are reactant and what are product. So in this, you can see that when 4.2 gram of NaHCO3 and 10 gram of CH3COOH is added. Added means these two are reactant. So the reactants are NaHCO3 and CH3COOH. Okay. And now you can see here 2.2 gram of CO2 is released and 12 gram of residue is formed. Okay. So this released CO2 and 12 gram of residue, they both are the product. So here CO2 plus residue. Okay, so these two are product. Now you have to add these two reactant. So it is 4.2 gram plus 10 gram. Now what are the product? CO2 and this residue. So the amount of CO2 is 2.2 gram and the residue is 12 gram. Now you just add this. It becomes 14.2 gram and here it also become 14.2 gram. Okay. So the mass of the reactant is equal to the mass of the product. So this data is in agreement with law of conservation of mass. The law of conservation of mass is a universal law. You can never disobey this law. So it will always in agreement with this law. And if any data which does not follow this law, means either the reaction is wrong or either we have the wrong experimental data. Okay. So the first law is that the mass of the reactant is always equal to the mass of the product. Now let us move to the second law. The second law is law of constant proportion. Now, this law states that whatever be the source of origin, any given compound will have its composition as the fixed one composition. Means if you have water as your compound, you can take water from ocean, from river, lake, fountain, tap, pond, from anywhere. The composition of the water remain H2O, means the number of atom of the constituent particles, means you have hydrogen and oxygen with you, then the hydrogen will remain two part and oxygen will remain one part. So whatever be the source of the origin, the composition of the compound will remain same. So you can say that the composition of any given compound will remain same irrespective of its source of origin. So let us take example. For example, if we have water with us, then the ratio of atom it is H is to O, it is 2 is to 1, and the ratio of mass will be 2 is to 16 or 1 is to 8. And if we take CO2, then the ratio of atom will be 1 is to 2, that is carbon is to oxygen is 1 is to 2, and the ratio of mass is 12 is to 32. So if you divide it further, it become, you can divide it by 4, so it is 3 is to 8. Okay, so means this ratio will remain constant. Now let us have some numerical problem on it. Now let us have our question number 2, which is based on the law of conservation of law of constant proportion. So let us read first of all that what the numerical says, that 1.375 gram of copper oxide was reduced and the weight of the copper was 1.098 grams. Okay, this is one reaction. In the another experiment, 1.1179 gram of copper was reacted with nitric acid and then converted into copper oxide. Now this was another reaction in which copper is getting converted into copper oxide and the weight of the copper was 1.76. So show that the results are in the agreement with the law of constant proportion. So we have to first of all see that what the reaction is. इस रिएक्शन में है क्या कि इस रिएक्शन में कॉपर ऑक्साइड कॉपर में कन्वर्ट हो रहा है और दूसरी रिएक्शन में कॉपर कॉपर ऑक्साइड में कन्वर्ट हो रहा है. तो पहली रिएक्शन क्या है, दैट CuO इज गेटिंग कन्वर्ट इनटू Cu प्लस O2, दिस इज द रिएक्शन. तो पहली रिएक्शन में 1.375 इज कॉपर ऑक्साइड एंड व्हाट इज द वेट ऑफ कॉपर हियर, 1.098. Okay, this is copper. ये पहली reaction. And second reaction is the next one, that CuO here it is formed with the help of the other reagents like HNO3 and with last one we have CuNO3 whole twice plus H2 and here this CuNO3 whole twice is getting reduced, it is ignited and it is converted into copper oxide. This reaction is going on. Now in this the data says that we will have 1.1179 grams, this is of material, and the last material is 1.476. okay, so here two data here and two data here for the next reaction. So what we have to do, hame karna kya hai, we have to just take the percentage of copper, hai na, percentage of copper in first reaction. So it is weight of copper upon weight of CuO into 100. So weight of copper is 1.098 into 100 and it is 1.375. Okay, yeah. So if you do this one, it comes to be little about 79.80, something like that it will come. Nah? So this much percentage will come. Now, here in the second reaction, you will do the same. Percentage of copper in second reaction. Here, the same formula, weight of copper upon weight of CuO into 100. So weight of copper is here 1.1179 divided by 1.476 into 100. So by the calculation, the answer comes to be 79.82% here. Okay, so here both the data are in the agreement. The same result you are getting. So means the percent of copper is same. So if the percent of copper is same, then the percent of oxygen will also be same. So the percentage of both the atom remains same in whatever way you make copper oxide from copper, or you make copper from copper oxide. So the percentage of the constituent atoms will remain same. So here we are ending our lecture. Now in the next lecture, we are going to study the law of multiple proportion. Till then, keep watching and keep sharing the video and do subscribe this channel, and please write your valuable comment in the comment section. Thank you.